Morning Knights, I'm Taryn Atley, and today is Thursday, September 10th, 2015.
And I'm Aaron Rapp, and welcome to Show 2 of Foothill Television. On today's show, we will visit with girls tennis, girls volleyball, and football after their big win on Friday. We will meet with Mrs. Ivory, our newest chemistry teacher, and we will also find out what's trending at Foothill.
I know what's trending. The boys' water polo team is on fire. We will hear more about their upcoming season and their narrow escape yesterday when they visit with FTV live on the couch later in the show.
Girls tennis swings into a new season. Reporter Jillian Berry and photographer Zane Ruoff talk to head coach Mr. Hermanson to get an insider's view on how this season will go.
So I'm Mr. Hermanson. I coach the girls varsity tennis team.
Who's your biggest coaching influence?
That would be Ms. Dusler, who's my assistant coach. She always teaches me to be calm, just let things slide, and take it one point at a time, so definitely her. Well, I played tennis in high school and college, and I've been coaching here at Foothill for 9 years.
Who are some of the players that we should watch out for?
Well, Emily Reyes is our number one singles player, and she's really, really good. She's improved a ton just in a couple of years. And then our number one doubles team of Allie Carter and Angie Ellingson, they were all-league last year, and I look for them to be all-league again. And then our number two doubles team, Jesse Haig and Haley Wittenberg, are also really strong players.
Which school is your biggest rival?
Oh, definitely El Dorado.
Oh, I'm Angie.
I'm Allie.
I like playing with Ange.
I like playing with Al, and it's like fun.
I like it better because we don't have to run as much.
Emily Reyes. I like the competitive aspect of it, and I love going out and competing.
How long have you been playing tennis?
I've been playing for 2 years.
Do you think you'll make it into CIF?
Yeah, I think we have a shot.
At Foothill, we like to welcome all new faculty and staff members. FTV's photographer Emily Perez and reporter Kyle Sun interviewed Mrs. Ivory, our newest chemistry teacher.
Hi, I'm Kyle Sun here with our newest chemistry teacher, Mrs. Ivory. You're watching FTV. Hi, Mrs. Ivory. What made you interested in teaching at Foothill?
I have been researching schools for several years. I taught for several years, and then I stayed home with my three children, and that gave me plenty of time to do a lot of research, and I started looking at where I wanted to teach when I returned to teaching. So I looked at the schools in different districts, and Foothill stood out to me, and I kept an eye on it, and when there was an opening, I made sure to get my application in, and here I am.
What is your favorite part of being a teacher?
Favorite part of being a teacher is just to be with energetic youth every day. You guys keep me on my toes, you're entertaining, and it's a challenge. It's a challenge to teach a rigorous subject like chemistry, and it's a rewarding when you guys get it. I wanted to be a teacher when I was a little girl. I used to play with my stuffed animals. I have a big chalkboard. I made my own mock classroom. I even sent my stuffed animals to the principal's office. I made them worksheets. Growing up, my father was like, no, teachers don't make enough money. You need to do something else. So I kind of abandoned that and looked for other careers when I was in high school. And after I graduated from college, I was a young woman in my 20s, and I said, you know what, the bug to still be a teacher is there, and so I re-enrolled in school in the graduate program to get my teaching credential, and here I am 10 years later.
Well, we're glad you're here.
Thank you,
Mrs. Ivory, for this interview.
Thank you, Kyle.
It's a new school year, and certain things are out, and other things are in. Reporter Sebastian Moreno and photographer Luis Nicasio talked to Foothill about what's trending.
I don't know, school's trending, you know?
School's trending, school in season.
Yeah. School just started like about a week ago.
We're definitely trending right now, guys.
Mm-hmm.
Everything you're wearing is trending. It's true.
School.
How do you feel about fanny packs coming back this style?
Actually, I need to pick up one of those designer fanny packs.
Definitely. What's trending?
Pajamas.
Oh my God!
this fine gentleman?
He's
a former president.
Obviously that's John D. Rockefeller.
President?
Obama?
It's not Obama. No, that was not right. That was Woodrow Wilson.
Okay, it was with a shot. Yeah.
This is fine gentleman.
That is a cooking star and, you know,
oh, that's a Guy Fieri.
That's Guy.
That's Guy Fieri. That's good old Guy Fieri.
Yeah.
Reporter Garrett Elms and photographer Connor Davis try to get a sense of what Foothill Girls Volleyball team is up to this year in our volleyball season preview.
Good morning, Knights. This is Garrett Elms. Today we're going to be interviewing Coach Mark and taking a look at the varsity girls volleyball team to see how they're doing for this season. Let's take a look.
All right. So, Coach, what are you looking forward to most this season?
Well, we're really young, but we have a few experienced players as well. So just seeing all of that come together every year, we're hoping to win league and then go deep into CIF. We got our seniors. We got Shannon and Taylor and Lauren. And then we've got a couple of solid freshmen.
What's your guys' favorite part about Foothill Volleyball?
The team becomes like a family, so it's really awesome to come to practice and go to tournaments with each other.
I feel like this year we've really come together a lot as a team.
Especially not even with varsity, but like with all of the teams. So like the whole entire volleyball program is one big family. We have big sisters. Like the varsity girls are big sisters, and we have JV and freshman girls who are little sisters.
Hey Foothill, I'm your sports anchor Gunnar Perales. Here's what's happening this week at Foothill in sports. Congrats to girls golf who won the Rosary Tournament last week. Boys water polo beat Capistrano Valley 16-6. Girls tennis plays Beckman today. Girls volleyball plays University High School at home at 5:15. We need the dungeon there, so everybody show up. On Saturday, both the boys and girls cross country teams are in the Running Brave Invitational. Good luck to them. On Friday night, football takes on Beckman in game two of their season. Last Friday night, Foothill held on to the win 13-7 and defeated the Tillers. Photographer Aaron Rapp and reporter Kat Villanueva filmed the action and caught up with Coach Case and some of the players at the end of the game.
It was our first game, so we were bound to make some mistakes, but overall it was a great game for the Knights, and I'm very proud of my guys for hanging in there at the end there with big defensive play to win the game for us.
Water polo kicked off its season last week with a few big wins. Reporter Eileen Harrison and photographer Nikki McClellan visited with Coach Brum on Tuesday.
Harrison from FTV, and today we'll be interviewing Coach Brum, coaching boys water polo. Okay, yeah, being the defending champions, I do think it is in grasp. I mean, it's definitely a big challenge to go out there and try to achieve that. I mean, it's something that we would all like to do, but I think at this time of the season, I think every team in the division has that same goal. So for us to go out there and achieve that, we're going to have to work hard and kind of lay it on the line every time we play. You know, actually our four seniors in our starting lineup are all very key for us. Griffin Gordon's our center, and Bobby Lee's our center defender. And then both Chaz and Chaz Hornecker and Mikey Miller are definitely very, very good. But I mean, every guy that we have in the pool is very critical. I always love the games. I mean, I like the competition part of it. I know I do like just being out here at practice every day. I do like it when the kids lay it on the line and work really, really hard. I like seeing that kind of sparkle in their eye when they know they've achieved something. So, you know, like again, you know, when you're playing a game and you win, or it's a big game and you win, I'd like to see the kids' the excitement.
And now joining us on the couch live in studio is FTV reporter Brooke Maxson, along with some members of the water polo team, Bobby Lee, Mikey Miller, Griffin Gorin, and Chaz Hornecker.
So Bobby, as we alluded to at the start of the show, the boys' water polo team is literally on fire with some big wins, but yesterday the bus was literally on fire. What happened?
So right when we're on the freeway, we're going and we see smoke in the back. So of course the bus driver pulls over because the engine dies. Pulls over, and so we all were like, what's happening? So I'm sitting down in the seat and my leg starts burning. And I was like, ow, like it's hot. and then smoke starts coming out under my seat. I'm like, oh shoot. All right, so we evacuate everyone out of the bus. Everyone gets on the side of the freeway. And the bus just starts smoking a lot. And then on the bottom of the bus, you see oil dripping. So, and then the oil's on fire. So just eventually over a period of around 15 minutes, the bus just starts getting more and more and more hot.
So Mikey, last year boys water polo won CIF. How much of that experience will help you guys win this year?
We had a great season last year. We put in a lot of work, and we all know what it's going to take to win again this year, that we have to work hard and not miss any opportunities that we have.
All right, Griffin, what was your preparation like this summer? What were like some of your practices like?
Lots and lots of swimming. This entire summer we practiced 4 days a week from Monday to Thursday and lifted weights. We played, well, seems like hundreds of games, but probably wasn't. We kept our hopes up and aimed high for the goals of this year, and I'm hoping that does pay off.
Very cool. Chaz, this year in CIF, who's going to be your biggest competition, and how are you going to beat them?
I think our biggest competition is going to be Dana Hills, most likely, and to beat them, we're just going to have to keep practicing, practicing a lot, and then keep playing good in our games, and we'll beat them.
Thank you. I'm Taryn.
And I'm Aaron.
Thanks for making FTV your choice on this Thursday.
As we end our show today, please enjoy the work of photographer McKaylee Manning as she shares the events of the past weekend's Foothill versus Tustin football game and all of its school spirit. Have a good weekend, Foothill.
Once upon a younger year, when all our shadows disappeared, the animals inside came out to play. Went face to face with all our fears, learned our lessons through the tears, made memories we knew would never fade. One day my father, he told me, son, don't let it slip away. He took me in his arms, I heard him say, when you get older, your wild heart will live for younger days. Think of me if ever you're afraid. He said one day you'll leave this world behind, so live a life you will remember. My father told me when I was just a child, these are the nights that never die. My father told me. can't put out. Carve your name into those shining stars. He said go venture far beyond the shores. Don't forsake this life of yours. I'll guide you home no matter where you are.